You know, I'm actually all caught with it. I know I sleep.
Yeah, well, I'm feeling better today. I'm not so sleepy.
You've got 1,500.
Straight up.
Straight up, Jim.
Double that back. I I but cheese room, bye.
Aye.
I
lady said that. Pardon?
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We're at the Big Guns second day. We've got an embarrassment of riches today. We're currently watching Rusty and Steve Woods. Woodsy just won that one, so Rusty's leading that match 5-3. We've got other matches, James Delahunty and Dave Rothall, with Dave Rothall actually leading that one 3-2. We've got Alex Evrenardis and Joel Younger also playing. And that one looks to be Alex Evrenardis up 2-1. We've got Ben Noonan versus Michael Skerry, which looks to be locked at 2 frames apiece. And we've also got Brett Rogers and Jamie Stevens, which is locked at 3 frames apiece at this stage. There's plenty of matches on the loser's side playing at the moment. Has just seen a nice break by Steve Woods there. Regulation clearance here. Yeah. Just take one nice shot. Should get him right into it. Shouldn't have too much trouble.
Yeah.
just a quick score update from the Dave Rothall James Delahunty match that is now locked at 3 frames apiece. Nice put into the centre there. Looks like he's left the other end into the opposite centre pocket. Should be able to run up table and not have too much trouble. Though the Pluck's in a bit of a difficult position here, so you might need to promote that out. Got a bit fortunate there with the light tickle off the yellow there. But he's got a natural angle to come back down. An unfortunate miss there by Steve. He's a little rusty in here. Just had one decent shot. Once Rusty gets in, he should be able to clear this out without too much trouble. And another match that's being played over on table one. We've got Kurt Dunham against a young player from Scotland, young McCauley. And Kurt Dunham is absolutely on fire. He's leading that one 6-1. It's a little bit of a tricky shot, this one, for Rusty. We come up against a run. That shows his class. Rolls it in without any problems whatsoever. Beautiful shot by Rusty there, just getting behind the player. Nice easy roll in the centre pocket. Regulation stuff there. Rusty showing the skills that took him to the quarterfinals at the World 8 Ball titles this year, actually. Make it easy. Now leading that match 6-3. Another match on the winner's side, we've got Jake McCartney versus Dale. Dale's actually one of the novice players in this tournament, who's running fairly well in the main draw here, still on the winner's side. He's got a big ask against Jake McCartney, very, very good player. Dale seems to be holding his own in that one. Unfortunately, I can't see the scores, so I can't update anybody at this stage. Beautiful spread of the ballsy by Rusty. either looks quite good. The reds look that little bit more promising. Yeah, I don't think he meant to play that shot there, but he might be able to run one of these reds into the centre pocket, into the right hand centre bag. Fantastic shot. Very awkward queuing up against the bottom rail there, but yeah, Rusty made it look quite simple. Should be nice and regulation. Well, this one in the center pocket. Regulation red black. Should be another one in the front of Rusty. And a lovely master break there by John Wheeler. Excellent stuff. He's very much on form today. Had a couple of decent wins yesterday, but he's certainly brought his A game today. He's really going to need to try and return the favour, having that master break against him there, just to try and keep in touch with John here. Oh, scratched off the break here. The balls are laying absolutely beautiful. There's another big chance for Rusty to do another run out here. Center here. Move this red and run down the bottom. Yeah. He's making it look very, very simple today. Very simple indeed. This should just be another stroke regulation out here. Probably run up a little bit higher there than what he would have. He doesn't have the natural angle now, but he should be able to come off two rails and get him behind the plaque, take it straight back into that same corner pocket. No, looks like he's appearing to take it into the centre. That's a bad miss. A player of Rusty's caliber should have got that. Just giving Steve Woods another go at this one here. Looks like it might have a touching ball. Six of Steve's balls are out in the open nicely, but he's just got that one just near the ball line over on the right hand side of the table. So he might do a roll up snooker here. Sitting very hard up against that yellow. Mm. Steve was trying to get that yellow off the rail there. He gave it a light tickle, but it didn't come out anywhere near as much as what he would have liked. So, wouldn't surprise me if we see another roll-up smoker here. He's up to take the yellow in the centre. Not a bad shot there, left it a little bit short, but looks like he might be looking at this yellow into the centre pocket, possibly to try and knock that yellow away from the side rail. Oh, he's cut that too thin, and he's conceded the frame. So that's Rusty up 8 frames to 3 now. He's starting to run away with this match and race to 11, I believe. The other matches all still appear to be the same. I can see that Brett Rogers and Jamie Stevens are now locked at 4 frames each. And Ben Noonan and Mick Scarry is at 3 frames to 2. Unfortunately, I can't see which way, but still a very tight match there also. Other notable players still in the tournament, albeit on the loser side of the draw. We've got JR, Peter Butterworth, Gus DiGiorgio, who played absolutely awesome pool yesterday. I watched a few of his matches and he played absolutely fantastically, including an 11-0 win over his second round opponent on the winner's bracket. Until he ran up against Ben Noonan and had a very tight match against Ben. Here we see Rusty out on the yellows. Yellows are sitting absolutely beautifully again. These new Riley tables that Ben's had put in here have just been breaking absolutely beautifully. Too far. It's quite a beautiful. Yeah, that one's rolled a little bit further than what he would have expected also, but oh, that's a lovely shot. Just a nudge off the side rail. Just a roll in yellow. Roll in black. There's another one on the board for Rusty. He's absolutely destroying it on these tables today, Rusty. He is not really missing all that much at all. That's Rusty up 9 frames to 3 now. James Telehundy's just taken the lead against Dave Rothall at 4 frames to 3. Kurt Dunham is up against the young fellow Macaulay from Scotland, 7 frames to 2. So he's really running away with it. Steve Woods has just done another beautiful break there. Like I said, these tables just been absolutely opening up lovely. Really giving the players the best opportunity to showcase their talents. We've got a couple of yellows jammed up against the side rail here, and a couple of reds as well, so yellows are probably the preferred option here. Just want to be careful not to shirt foul here, he's very, very close to this yellow. Yeah, beautiful shot by Steve. Left himself a beautiful angle here on this yellow to come off the bottom rail and try and knock the two yellows out from the side rail here. And did it absolutely beautifully. Absolutely beautiful. can take this one in the centre bag. Oh, it looks like he's got the angle there to do that. A little bit hard to tell if that other yellow goes in the corner pocket. I think it might, but from this angle it's just a little bit difficult to see. Is it this one in the corner pocket? Ah, beautiful. Also, he's going to run this one straight down in the bottom corner, try and kick the wobble across the table. Ooh, it rattled in the jaws, but it's in the end, it finally decided to drop. This should be a regulation yellow and black here for Steve. Shot there. It's not the easiest black ball in the world, but a player of Steve's quality should be able to get this without too much problem. As I say that, he's jawed it out. He's given Rusty a chance here. He's got a couple of difficult-ish sort of reds there, but in the way that he's been hitting the ball, wouldn't put it past him. Certainly would not put it past him to clear out from here. He's going to try and take this one now, right on the right hand side here. The match between Joel Younger and Alex Avranatis is now locked at 2 frames apiece. Well, I thought in the form that Rusty was in, he would have actually had a go at that out, but he's decided to play it smart and laid up a beautiful snooker there. I've seen these get potted in the centre pocket on more than one occasion. Very difficult shot, but looks like that might be the way he's going with it. Oh, it's a great try by Steve. And a good leave as well. So, Rusty's certainly going to play this shot right, otherwise he's going to leave Steve with the black ball in the centre of the table and leave plenty of options as to where to put it. That was a great attempt, very stiffer to Joel, but he drew back that just that little bit to make this next shot very, very difficult. He can't really play it down in the bottom corner if he has a shot at it, because he's got the in-off sitting looking right in the face. Steve's really got to think about this shot here. As Kurt Dunham chalks up another frame, so he's now leading 8 frames to 2. It was an interesting shot. Now it's left Rusty with a nice open table here to have a go at the run out here. He's left that one a little bit shorter than what he would have liked, but he's still got this red over the centre pocket here that he can use to get himself right back in. He missed that. That is absolutely regulation stuff for a player of Rusty's quality. Just took it way too easy.
Jesus.
I think I heard it. Yeah. Steve's got one back here, so I think I heard Rusty saying that someone was talking while he was down on his shot, so might be a little bit annoyed with that. But Steve gets one from there. So now scratching in the centre pocket. He looks a little bit annoyed with himself. There's a little bit of traffic down the bottom end of the table. So I have a lot of matches on both the winners and losers sides on today. James Delahunty is taking the lead in his match against Dave Rothall, 5 frames to 3. Jamie Stevens, Brett Rogers matches at 5 frames to 4. And the match between Ben Noonan and Mark Scarry is locked at 3 frames all. At the completion of this match between Rusty and Steve Woods, we'll be heading over to look at the Dave Rothall James Delahunty match. Once again, I'd like to thank Dan Lynch and Q-Ball TV for putting all this on for everybody. So even if you couldn't be here, you can still see what's happening. And also to Ben Noonan and Georgia Lou from Bar 8 for hosting this event over this weekend. Rusty's on yellows here. Just promoted the black just down a little bit, use it to hold the white ball. Maybe a little bit the wrong side of the yellow here, but should be able to roll through and continue on. Looks like we're taking this one down the rail here. That one in, but it sat just nicely in the pocket anyway. Steve Woods got a couple of tough reds here if he wanted to attempt the out, but it's certainly a good enough play to do it. This is a big shot here. If he knocks this one in, he could be a chance of running out his balls. That looked for all the world like it was going to run in. Right, it's just set in the pocket. That's a fantastic shot by Rusty. Beautiful control. The only question is, where's he going to try to put the black ball? The Brett Rogers-Jamie Stevens match is now locked at 5 frames apiece. Both players have been playing absolutely beautifully today too, so. He's left himself an angle here where he can actually run into the black if he chooses to. A little bit of awkward cueing, but. That is an absolutely beautiful shot. Tough shot to play on these new tables. Shots out around, unless you really hit them beautifully. They have been sitting in the pockets like we saw with Steve's. But Rusty made absolutely no problem with that. And that puts him at the hill at 10 frames to 4. Young McGawley from Scotland is taking another frame back off Kurt Dunham, so that's now at 8 frames to 3. And the match between Alex Avranatis and Joel Younger is at 3 frames to 2. There's been quite a few very tactical frames there. not a lot of break and runs. Over to the left hand side of the table. Just going to take this one up the top by the looks of it. Beautiful shot. Absolutely beautiful. This shot in here, it's certainly no gimme in order to get back down. And the pace was absolutely beautiful. But he is long short of the red in order to just draw back and sit nice on the black, so. Yeah, it was a tough shot to get back with a decent shot on the black. Set there. The yellows are pretty open for Steve Woods. He should be able to clear this out. Don't know what happened here. He got a kick or just didn't kill it right, but he's left himself not the easiest shot in the world. He's going to run the waffle a little bit far up the table than what he would have liked. That's a lovely shot, beautiful pace. He's put himself back and had a chance to clear those yellows out and get one frame back. This ball, yeah, just roll it in a dead weight because the black's sitting right over the pocket. And that's a beautiful clearance by Steve Woods. Gonna make Rusty earn this one. He's not just gonna roll over and give it to him, so that brings it back to 10 frames to 5. Dave Rothall's taken one frame and pegged the deficit back by one, so he's now only trailing 5 frames to 4. His match is James Delahunty. Scratch off the break here. The black, red, and yellow over on the right hand side are really the only difficult balls on the table. Everything else is right out in the open. Let's take a closer look at the yellows here. He's gonna have to get that one out that's near the black ball, but. Sort of run right in between positions there. little bit shorter, a little bit further would have been ideal, but he's still got the one over the pocket that he can use to get back in if he needs to. There by Steve Woods trying that thin cut and also to knock him out, but he almost put the black ball in the centre pocket there, sitting right there.
You're all there, mate.
No, that's
killing.
Rusty and Steve having a bit of a laugh there about the result of that shot. Fantastic double, reverse double there by John. He's hit that absolutely beautifully. Characteristicness. Balls here are sitting absolutely beautiful for Steve Woods. The clearance here should not be too difficult. Had a little fortune on that shot, but it's a perfect position. This should be absolutely regulation stuff here. For James Delahunty, match with David Rothall is now locked at 5 frames apiece. The young player from Scotland, young McCauley, has taken another one back off Kurt Dunn. He's now back to 8 frames to 4. He's really, really putting in an excellent effort here. I've seen him, some of his opponents that he's played against. He beat Peter Butterworth, I believe the score was 11-8 or 11-9, which is no mean feat. Peter Butterworth's a very good player. Steve Woods plays a beautiful shot there. Easy black over the bag. They'll peg it back to 10-6. Dry breaks I've seen on this table. Rusty knocks in the red there. Probably play this one up the rail here. In the match between Joel Younger and Alex Evrenardis, Joel's taken a bit of a lead there, he's now up 4 frames to 2. That was a tough shot to play, but it looks like he's taking control of the black with that red. In any case, so it's going to make the pot out a lot harder here for Steve. It's a beautiful shot. Steve has started finding his range in the last couple of frames. And he's been hitting the ball a lot better, a lot cleaner. And he's certainly good enough to take the next five and get the win, but it's a bit of a mountain to climb. And he can't really afford to make any more mistakes at all. Fantastic shot there. He'll use this yellow near the black to knock Rusty's red out of the way and hold for the yellow into the centre pocket. As I said before, he's really started to find his feet in the last couple of frames. Once again, it's another difficult shot here. Well, it's never easy when the cue ball's up hard against the rail like that. He's run that one about 4 to 6 inches further than what he would have liked, but he can drop it in the centre, stun across the table to stun that block. That's a fantastic shot by Steve. Ooh, wiped its feet, but it has dropped, so Steve's really showing his true form here. He's picked the deficit back to 10 frames to 7. He's really making Rusty in this one. There's a match from Jimmy Duller and Dave Rothall here. Here we go, Rusty's about to break. Yeah, the yellow drops into the centre pocket there. Rossi's nominated the red balls. They're sitting absolutely beautifully, so one good shot, kept prime position. This could be another master break here. Stand there. Yeah, lovely shot. Prime position here. Stand across. So when this one moves it on. A lot of chips. That is a brilliant shot. Absolutely brilliant. Should be a regulation red plug here. and great out. There we go, there's the win to John Wheeler, 11 frames to 7 over Steve Woods. Absolutely beautiful demonstration of potting and so forth there. As we come over and we look at James Delahunty up against Dave Rothall.